As I'm trying to get more serious with my YouTube channel and maybe someday be capable of living with the channel. If you like and subscribe all my stuff, maybe I get then more than one subscribers and get some money from Google. I think if you like these videos, it'd be nice if you support me. I bought me for better video production with my EM1. I bought me a small assistant monitor. This is the A7 4K camera assist. Yeah, so let's unbox it. It's quite a rough packaging. So I think this is a display. Let's see first what's supplied with. You get an HDMI to mini HDMI cable. Nice. You get a small 1/3 mount ball head and also an adapter for the lightning shoe of your camera. You get some screw 1/4 inch for something. You get this adapter for the battery pack, and you get some sun protection. I think on other displays you got to buy it also. Then let's see how the display looks. It's quite light, the display. There are some scratches on top, but it's only the foil. Now you see a clear screen. You get an HDMI in, out. You can connect your earphones. I think you get Weather 10 mount here. 1/4 inch thread mount here. This is this rubber protection outside. You get some on exit, some menu wheel, quite handy. Oh, you get thread mount on top and on the back, and I think if you insert this, you can also put something on top like an video light or so. So yeah, you don't lose your screw. So let's try it out. I got here a small micro HDMI to HDMI male adapter and then also a small female HDMI to female HDMI cable, the standard one, because this camera has a micro HDMI connector. Then we need let's start with a 12 volt 2 amps power supply. This should be 24 watts, more than enough if it is capable of driving from battery. The nice thing about this display is it can process 4K videos on the input, but will scale it down to full HD as is the native resolution of the panel. So let's see see. So, yeah, you see field monitor, and you see you get a small histogram, and that's it. You can control the brightness directly with the wheel. Nice thing is if you control the brightness of the monitor, your histogram changes. Quite interesting. Then you get some peak marking. Get a small level measure. So let's try this out. This fits. It was not correctly inserted by me, so everything is okay. I thought they fixed it, so you are only capable of viewing the video if you have some picture on your camera. So let's make a co a small picture. As you can see, you get as an input the full HD stuff. You see your different brightness level, but so to get more professional, I got to change my camera. This can stay as a travel camera or so on, so it's capable of recording the 4K inputs. So let's try another device with micro HDMI output. So this is the E4K with live streaming. So it, I think it's quite handy to get an video output of it. So let's turn it on and see what's happened. You get also the 4K video input, but as you can see, you only get this cropped two pictures and loose. This is the micro HDMI connection. It's always here if I shake it a little bit, so it's not the best connection. But this is my adapter and not that from the video. So yeah, it's working. It's quite bright. I like it. It's quite reflective, but I think with this sun protection, it will work good. So the next thing would be to upgrade from a to upgrade from EM1 to maybe as is there the peak marking? This is the on-on switch. So yeah, you see it's everything red marked, which is in peak, which is oversaturated or undersaturated. So yeah, the thing is quite nice. I like it. It's quite robust with this rubber protection thing, and I can highly recommend it if you have a camera which is capable of working with it. So stay tuned after I get a camera update. Maybe it's the Panasonic G5, or if I have enough money, which I get if you support me, use my raffles and so on, to get the 5GS with the super low light performance capable to the Sony Alpha A7S2. So support me and I will be surprised. Like and subscribe.